welcome to the Connect Summit. I am Tanina Ellison Jones.
And I am Courtney Jones.
And together we are
Chicago Home Realty Group
for Property Management. So yes, I am in business with my husband. I know a lot of people are like, really? So we wanted to share with you a little bit about our journey and our take on success not being an island unto itself.
And I have the pleasure of having my managing broker be my wife.
So I'll share a little bit about my background. Again, I'm Tanina Ellison Jones. Prior to getting into real estate, I worked for Chase for 12 years as a banker in various capacities. My last stint with JPMorgan Chase was as a business banker where I was licensed, investment license series 6 and 63. So with that financial background, that and real estate weren't necessarily the direction that I thought I was going to go into. So what we're going to talk a little bit about today is how the past leaves clues for you and connects those dots when you might not have even actually connected them yourself.
And I'm Courtney Jones. I've spent 17 years with JPMorgan Chase. I started as an investment rep, managing a portfolio of $150 million on Long Island, New York. Been relocated three times with the beautiful task of building up three markets. Then got recruited to the home lending side of the business and did that, and that's how I finished up here in Chicago.
Okay, so we'll start out with a quote from one of my favorite books. How many of you are familiar with the book The Outliers by Malcolm Gladwell? Okay, so the book is about the story of success, not directly linked to what we're talking about today, but I was able to link the two. In my opinion, it actually is a direct link, and I'll take a direct quote from the book, which kind of summarizes how I like to tie the story of success to success not being on an island. It's not the brightest who succeed, nor is success simply a sum of decisions and efforts we make on our own behalf. It is rather a gift. Outliers are those who have been given opportunities, who have had the strength and the presence of mind to seize them. So I'll share with you a little bit more about what we mean by that. Have you guys ever heard the quote, if you will, of the man who pulled himself up by his bootstraps, right? Well, we're here to demyth that myth, debunk that myth, because I don't believe that to be the truth. Opportunities are everywhere. So we look a little bit into our past. Again, starting with JPMorgan Chase, that kind of morphed into a number of different opportunities for us, which we were able to then start to connect the dots. And getting licensed as a younger real estate professional, I was able to connect the financial analytics that I already was using at JPMorgan to the analytical ability in real estate. You want to share a little bit about your experience, Courtney?
Yes, in regards to the outlier piece, and I'm going to make this really silly for me because this is a debate we have. When you pull into a Walmart and someone pulls out and you get that spot, would you say you were successful or would you say you were lucky? I would say extremely lucky. So my dad used to pound in me and my brother's head this equation, and I know most of us have all heard it. When preparation meets success is inevitable. And that's kind of where the outlier story is, because most of us in this room have had tremendous background experiences where we've built skills that we've never even realized we built. And that's what the book touches on in that specific quote that motivates us on an everyday when we get on each other's nerves.
Your past leaves clues for you. So there were a series of events leading up to the beginning of Chicago Homes Realty Group that actually helped to lead to where we are today, none of which were intentionally related to one another. I'll give you an example. When I started in real estate full-time, I actually quit my job. Yes, my full-time benefits, every two-week paycheck job to go into entrepreneurship. So how many entrepreneurs do we have in the room today? So you guys kind of feel me on that, right? There's this energy that we have as entrepreneurs where we're so passionate about what we do and we're just so excited about it that we leap, take this leap of faith. And I encourage you all to do so. But I took the leap of faith, and I joined a small real estate brokerage. And in talking with my pastor, I wasn't exactly happy where I was, but I did say to him, you know, I can see myself starting a company, but I think I'll probably give it about 5 years. Well, it took about 9 months. And 9 months later, we were in business. Courtney at the time was working for, who were you working for, Courtney?
Let me back up a second. You heard her say she quit her job. I won't back up to that. So, as an analytical household, quitting your job did not sound exciting to me. But it's funny how, like she said, these clues kind of motivate you. So, after 10 mergers in the bank, the last merger, my side of the house loses. So when you've had a successful career, the benefits, the stock options, all the cushy things that entrepreneurs are kind of, at least in my case, was afraid to leave, right? Because this is how I sustain my family. So now when I get to that path and then I have my ambitious wife talking about, let's do it, we're jumping in with 2 feet. I'm just thinking about mortgage, car loan, insurance, and so forth. But what was exciting was if I could go out and do a pitch in a new market like a Houston for JPMorgan Chase, why couldn't I do it for us, right? If I go out on client calls and I'm in Salma Smith Barney and different companies, why couldn't I pitch my wife and I? The value proposition in all of us in this room lies in the skills we bring to the table. We make the product important, right? That was the key clues that I took for granted that in coaching, and we'll touch on it, really helped bring it to the surface in the confidence standpoint.
So, and before we change lives there, if I can just encourage anyone in terms of connecting the dots, because that you'll hear a theme here, everything that you need, you already have right in front of you. So the dots are already there. It's just a matter of putting the pieces of the puzzle together to make them make sense into leading into your journey. Next, relationships create alliances. So one of the things that I've learned as a servant leader is you always want to continue to build and grow in the relationships that you continue to develop throughout your career. As Courtney knows, I like to help people, right? So I'm a servant by heart. So I've joined a number of boards and organizations. That's just something that's passionate for me to continue to do. But in doing that, it's helped me in enormous ways. Joining these different boards and organizations, you're sitting at the table, and oftentimes, in my case, with similar people in the same industry, right? So you may say to yourself, well, why would you want to be in the same room with or at the same table with people that are doing the same thing as you? But what I find is that you tend to learn an enormous amount from your colleagues, from your peers. So instead of having a competitive mindset, I have a very collaborative mindset, right? So I've learned how to use better tools and just how to better myself and my business and expand and grow. So I think relationships definitely help to create alliances. We've also seen those alliances start to blossom into monetary opportunities, right? So if we just stick to real estate because that's what I do. In partnering with another one of our colleagues, we actually have a very specific example where we work in residential real estate. We had not had at the time a property management background. That kind of morphed out of a relationship that we built with one of our colleagues. It was a space that she was not in either, but in referring and trusting her trusted colleagues, she referred that business over to us. Now this came as a matter of a couple of referrals, and we were like, well, no, we don't do that. No, we don't do that. But by the time we got the third referral, I figured we might as well do that. So we did that. And our property management business kind of morphed as a result of that. You want to share a little bit more?
Actually, just in the collaborative piece of alliance, I'm big in this piece because at the end of the day, we can only grow by the experiences that we get. And I'm going to touch on a few things because she's being humble. This is why I get to brag on her. She is the local board president of the Women's Council of the National Association of Real Estate Brokers. She's a trustee. Yeah, she's a trustee of our church, Bryce Miller Church of God in Christ. And I can continue and continue, but I want to stay within the timeline. And she encouraged me and joining the Dearborn Realtors Board, which is an African American Real Estate Trade Association here in Chicago a year ago, with coaching and learning, I'm now local board president. So the key to this is, in real estate and in any business that we're all in, being around like-minded people where you can learn from, exchange ideas, are things that I think most of us entrepreneurs take for granted. And joining these different boards is what motivates us to start sharing ideas. And without that, the growth that we've been blessed to have, we would not have. You know, going to organizations and partnering with CIC, being a part of the Sunshine Cohort, I mean, I could just spend 30 minutes just talking about that motivation that we received, that B12 shot that we received from attending that specific real estate cohort.
So no man can achieve enormous success on his own. You'll hear that from Bill Gates and all of the top that are in their industry. You will find that they've actually collaborated, partnered, and they surround themselves by those that do the best at what they do, and they do the best at what they do, if that makes sense. Right, so you find the one that does what they do really well, and you surround yourself with those people. I'll leave you with this. So I'm sure you've heard the story again, like I said at the beginning, of the man who pulled himself up by his bootstraps. So I'm here to tell you today that that is a lie, okay? So the next time you hear that guy tell that story, don't call him a liar, okay? You might start a fight. But at least just think to yourself, perhaps he's missing and not connecting the dots of all of the variables that have led up to the success that he's experiencing today. I'm gonna leave you guys with a quick video. And again, I'm Sydina Ellison Jones for Chicago Homes Realty Group.
And I'm Courtney Jones from Chicago Homes Realty Group.
And we thank you guys so much. I wish you all the best in your success as entrepreneurs. And thank you for the opportunity to speak with you today.
There's a lot of damn money in the world, people. Come on. I know the church folks are like, she just like that. She said, yes, rip your wigs, church folks. Rip your wigs. I said, damn. I say that because why don't we collaborate as a people, as a unit, as minorities? Why don't we collaborate? Like, we think that there's not enough money. Yeah, you got a business, I got a business. We can all win. Because you know what? When we help others, it's an automatic win for you. But no, as minorities, we want to hoard all the money ourselves, right? Like it's a shortage of money in the world. Which is crazy, because I don't know what that means to say. There is a lot of money out there, and a lot of people spending the money just because. Oh, don't get it twisted. I'm not saying all minorities, because my Hispanic people, they are messing. People collaborate, okay? They collaborate. When one of us come up, we all coming up. When you get a house, we all get a house. So next time, when you see 20 Mexicans get out of one car, think about it, collaboration. And on top of that, all 20 of them live together. Why? Because they're stacking the coins. They're stacking the money. And once the coins are stacked, we buy a lawn equipment because we start a lawn company. All the families go work for the lawn company and construction company, and y'all get new houses. Don't forget the restaurants. Yeah, we opened up some restaurants. And on top of that, we own a house and chains of restaurants. And we all gonna be rich. All. The point of this rant is get with like-minded people. Support their business. They'll support yours. You got bundles? I got a beauty shop. You have skincare products? Well, I have a salon. You are a realtor? Well, I flip houses. Come on, people, collaborate. There is a huge, huge world out there, and they're all waiting to be your customer.